Genesis chapter 3 verses 3 to 6. But God did say, "You must not eat fruit from the tree that is in the middle of the garden, and you must not touch it, or you will die." "You will not certainly die," the serpent said to the woman. "For God knows that when you eat from it, your eyes will be opened, and you will be like God, knowing good and evil." When the woman saw that the fruit of the tree was good for food and pleasing to the eye, and also desirable for gaining wisdom, she took some and ate it. She also gave some to her husband who was with her, and he ate it. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. This entire passage is so much on faith, right? Yes? Yes?
Yes.
Yes?
Yes?
Yes. Is this passage on faith? Brothers and sisters, this is a very common passage. Genesis, the first book of the Bible. Is this a passage on faith? What did Eve do? Ate the fruit. She was deceived by the serpent. In short, she was deceived by Satan. She obeyed Satan. God said, "Do not eat the fruit of that tree." But what she did? She ate it. She ate it and she gave it even to her husband. Where is faith in this, brothers and sisters? We are not thinking. We are not reading. Whatever the speaker is saying, we are saying yes to it. Today, this is our problem. How many of us have Bibles in front of us? Everybody has the scripture in front of them. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise
the
Lord.
This passage does not tell us on faith anyway. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
This passage tells us about betrayal. Many of us will think today's topic is on faith. From where betrayal came. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Many will say today's topic was on faith. Where disobedience came. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Brothers and sisters, obedience to the word gives rise to faith. Obedience to God's word gives rise to faith. See what the first line says. But God did say. Who said?
God
said, "You must not eat fruit from the tree that is in the middle of the garden." The word was spoken. God spoke his word. What did Eve do? Disobey the word. She betrayed who? She betrayed God. Everything was with Eve. Everything was with Adam. The entire garden belonged to them. Yeah? Yes? Everything in that garden. Every tree belonged to them. Every animal belonged to them. They could use everything. They had everything. But what Eve wanted? She wanted more. She wanted more. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Today, our worldly desires, today, our personal desires, today, our greed has come in between our faith. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. What has come in between our faith?
Greed.
Today, we have enough for ourselves. Yes?
Yes.
But we are not satisfied. We are not at peace. Eve had everything. Eve had the entire world, in short. At that time, that much only was the world. But no, she wanted more. In the Bible, here it is given. God really said, "You must not eat the fruit from that tree in the garden." The serpent asked Eve. Praise the Lord. Brothers and sisters, Keep this in mind. Obedience to the word gives rise to faith. She did not have faith in God. She did not have faith in God. God said, you have everything. Serpent said, you do not have anything. She did not obey the word. She did not have faith in God. At last it led to death. At last it led to death. They were thrown out, and after some years they had to die. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Today, are we in the same situation? Is the question for you and me. Yes? Where is our faith? Everybody said that, yes, I have faith. Yes, I have faith. Every Christian you ask, brothers and sisters, they will say they have faith. But the point is, do we really obey the word to have faith? Faith can be tested when you are really into a problem. When you are really into a problem and you are scared and you start crying, your faith is being tested. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Yes.
This is one example in the Bible. Let's go to the next example. Matthew chapter 26 verses 47 to 50. Another very common passage in the Bible. While he was still speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived. With him was a large crowd armed with swords and clubs sent for the chief priest and the elders of the people. Now the betrayer had arranged a signal with them. The one I kiss is the man. Arrest him. Going at once to Jesus, Judas said, "Greeting, Rabbi," and kissed him. Jesus replied, "Do what you came for, friend." Then the man stepped forward, seized Jesus, and arrested him. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise.
Second passage on, what was the first passage on? Faith. First passage was on faith.
Betrayal.
What is the second passage on?
Same.
Betrayal. Amen. Hallelujah. Are you all awake?
Yes.
What is this passage on? Betrayal. Everybody knows Judas Iscariot.
Yes.
The passage is talking about them. Hallelujah.
Praise
the Lord. Praise the Lord. What did he do? He betrayed Jesus. He was disobedient to Jesus. He was a man that used to live with Jesus. He was a man that used to attend Jesus's every talk. He knew the word. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Praise
the Lord. What did he do? He sold Jesus for
money.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
What came in between?
Greed.
What came in between?
Greed.
Personal desire. What came in between? Worldly desires. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Brothers and sisters, Jesus didn't get cheated. It was already told by Jesus that one of mine will betray me. Jesus didn't get cheated, but Jesus showed us this passage is an eye-opener for you and me that our very own person can betray us. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Today we have faith on our father, we have faith on our mother, my sister, or my brother, or my loved one, or my neighbor, or my uncle, or my auntie, or my friend, my dear friends. They all can betray you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise
the Lord. No human being on this earth will not think about themselves first and then you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The person who used to walk with Jesus, who used to roam with Jesus, who used to eat with Jesus, betrayed him. But God was showing us that he betrayed actually not him, but the word. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
And this is an eye opener for you and me. Do not have faith in your fellow brothers and sisters. Today what happens? Something happens. We are in problem. We start calling each other. We are impatient. We start calling each other. Hello, this is what happened. Ehzane, kit koru, kit korpache. That person doesn't know itself how to handle his or her own problem. And you think she will sort out your problem? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Brothers and sisters, let's open our eyes today. We say we have faith, we have faith. But you know, we have faith in who? In the wrong people. We have faith in who? Not in God. When we are in trouble, we don't run to God, but we run to other people. Now they know their own brother, sister, mother, father cannot do anything. So they run to a priest. They will run to a priest. Please pray for me. I have such and such problem. Or today in the modern times, they run to a pastor. I have so and so problem. But where is your God gone? The question is, where is your God gone? Is your God a dead God?
No.
Is your God a dead person?
No.
Your God cannot see. Your God cannot hear. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
When Jesus died on the cross, he was alive and he died. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise
the Lord. He's a God who can understand you. He's a God who can hear you. He's a God that can see you. He's a God that knows what is going on right now in your hearts. He's a God that knows what is troubling you right now. He is a living God. And leaving him, we go to every other person. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. This is the second passage on betrayal. Let's go to the third passage. Another very common passage. Matthew chapter 26 verse 74. Matthew chapter 26 verse 74. Then Peter said, I swear that I am telling the truth. May God punish me if I am not. I do not know that man. Just then a rooster crowed. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Yes,
praise the Lord.
Yes,
praise the Lord.
Yes,
who was Peter? Was a disciple, a very close disciple. More than Judas Iscariot was Peter. What did Peter do? Rejected Jesus three times. Again, Jesus was not cheated. Jesus told well in advance, before the cock crows three times, you will betray me. And that is what has happened. Today the Lord is telling us, your very own person is going to betray you. If not today, then tomorrow for sure. And that is going to badly hurt us. When someone of our own betrays us, we are hurt. We are shattered. We are in depression. We cannot take that feeling. But it is not God's fault. God has written everything in his Bible. God has told us everything. Do not trust your close people. But what do?
We trust
them itself. When a problem comes, what do? We call them up. Many of y'all over here, I know, who even calls people up. I hope this is an eye-opener for y'all. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Yes,
praise the Lord.
Yes,
praise the Lord.
Yes,
now these three passages were on betrayal. These three passages were on disobedience. The first one was when Eve obeyed Satan and disobeyed God. The second one was Judas Iscariot sold Jesus for a price money. Third was Peter, who was a very close disciple of Jesus, sold Jesus for his name. He sold him for his name. He did not want his name to go down. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Let's go forward. Genesis chapter 17 verses 1 to 2. When Abraham was 99 years old, the Lord appeared to him and said, I am God Almighty. Walk before me faithfully and be blameless. Then I will make my covenant between me and you and will greatly increase your numbers. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Yes, sir.
What is this passage on?
Hope.
Okay. Everyone knows Abraham, right?
Yes.
Everybody knows the work of Abraham. An entire teaching was given in the same hall on Abraham. How was Abraham? Did Abraham disobey Jesus like Eve, Peter or Judas Iscariot?
He was obedient.
He was very obedient. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
You know, how was Abraham? Abraham so loved the God that he didn't care for anything. He did not care for any blessing. He did not want anything. He did not even want a son. And he did not even want descendants. But God gave him everything. Hallelujah.
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 Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. God tested Abraham at the start. He saw his little faith. Little faith he saw. When he said, yes, he's a faithful man, I shall test him more. What God said? Give me your son. Aren't our children precious to us?
Yes.
Yes. If God asks for them, will you give it up?
No.
Where is the faith gone? And at the start, everybody said, yes, we have a lot of faith. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You see the eye opener?
Hallelujah.
God told Abraham, I want your son. Abraham said, take God. Take it. You gave it. You only take it.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
And after God saw that Abraham was so faithful, he promised him with many descendants. From Abraham to Isaac, Isaac to Jacob, Jacob, and then the entire Bible, and even you and me are included.
Hallelujah.
This was the faith of Abraham. He remained firm with the word. He remained close to God. He did not betray him. He did not say, Lord, I have faith in the beginning, but oh, when you ask for my son, sorry, that is precious to me. After so many years, my wife Sarah got conceived and you're asking for my son. But no, he said, take it.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise
the Lord.
This
is the first passage on obedience. This is the first passage on obedience and also faith.
Hallelujah.
This passage is on faith. Next. Genesis chapter 6 verse 9. This is the account of Noah and his family. Noah was a righteous man, blameless among the people of his time, and he walked faithfully with God.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
During Noah, how many people know Noah? No? So few people. How many are Christians? Raise. I want to know how many are Christians. Let the truth come out. Be it a believer or a Roman Catholic or even some other faith that uses the Bible, please raise your hands. Some are very shy because they know that they do not know the Bible. Noah, you do not know Noah? Noah, exactly, the flood, the boat, the ark.
Hallelujah.
Oh, now I remember. Praise the Lord. Okay. Noah was the man. Noah and his family were the only people that were saved.
Hallelujah.
Why was Noah only saved? Because he was
righteous.
He was righteous. He was, other word for righteous?
Obedient.
Obedient. Then Come on, you all know the words.
Faithful.
Amen. This is the second passage on faith. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Why did God save Noah and his family? Because he was faithful to him. He was obedient to him. His entire family obeyed God. And because the entire family obeyed God, God worked into his life. Everybody was destroyed. Everybody was destroyed in that storm. But God saved whom?
Noah.
Because Noah had faith in God. Storm symbolizes what? Problem in our life, right? It was a big problem for Noah. And it was very tricky for him whether to really trust what God is saying. Because the people around him are all going to die. And God is telling Noah, I will save your family. It was very tricky for him. But still, Noah chose to obey God. Hallelujah. If we were in a situation, we would be like, where the entire world is going, I too shall go there. I don't know if this person talking is really God or who. Really? Right?
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Where is the faith gone? Amen. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Then the same Genesis chapter 6 verse 22 says, Noah did everything. Everything Noah did exactly as God had commanded him. Exactly, he did everything what God had commanded him. Genesis chapter 6 verse 22. Genesis chapter 6 verse 22 says that Noah did everything exactly what God had commanded him. Today the Lord is commanding us many things, right? Yes. Through what? What do we have in our hands? The word of God. Are we obedient to the word? And then we say we have faith.
Hallelujah.
Let me come back to the first thing. Obedience to the word gives rise to faith. We are not obedient to the word, but we tell others we have faith in God. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Let's go to the next scripture. 1 Samuel chapter 17 verses 41. Meanwhile, the Philistine with his shield bearer in front of him kept coming closer to David. I will read it from my Bible. 1 Samuel chapter 17 verses 40. I can't go in these, he protested to Saul. I am not used to them. So David took them off again. Where was David going? David, Saul, David was going somewhere. Any connection? Anybody knows what I'm talking about? Goliath. Yes, David and Goliath. Another very common passage of the Bible. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
A small boy David goes to fight a huge man Goliath. And what Saul? Saul was the king that time. Saul and none of his Israelite army could defeat Goliath. But David, a small boy, said, I will go to defeat him. And Saul said, take everything. Take my shield, take my sword, take my arrow. And when David wore it, he found uncomfortable. No, I cannot fight him in this. Brothers and sisters, you know what is the meaning of this? Saul gave him his things. Saul was giving him his ideas, his thoughts. And what David said? No. David said no to it. But David chose to take stones to hit Goliath.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
David didn't choose to listen to other people or his neighbor, but he chose to be, to use the strength that God gave him. David was very good with his stones. At the start also he said that I used to take care of my father's sheep, and when wolves used to come, I used to hit them with those stones. So that was the strength given to him by God. But what was Saul giving him? His own ideas, his own
thoughts,
wisdom. But David said no to man, but took the strength of God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Another scripture that tells us about faith, that David had faith in God. Obedience to the word gives rise to faith. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Many such examples that we can see. Jesus heals the blind, right? The blind man had faith. Yes. Amen. Another thing is when the woman with the bleeding disease touches the cloak of Jesus, she had faith. Jesus didn't know anything. He was just walking in the crowd. She caught hold of his cloak. She had faith. Her faith healed her. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Now let us come back to the same question which I asked you before. How many of y'all still have faith? How many of y'all are still into the word, in other words? Amen. How many of y'all are connected to God? How many of y'all in your problem, in that storm, will say, Lord, nothing can shake me if you are with me. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Another example, how many of y'all know that when the disciples were in the boat, Jesus was sleeping, and the disciples got all scared because of the storm. They started screaming and telling Jesus, save us, save us. And they said, you people are so much little faith. Why do you get scared? Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
That storm was a problem in their life. Each one of us today have problems, right, brothers and sisters? If I look at your faces today, I'm not saying you all are alone in problem. Even I'm in problem today. But today we have to decide that who we are going to share our problem with. Are we going to go to our neighbor or a man, or we are going to directly go to God?
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Today, first we have to build our connection with God. We have to be obedient to God. If we are not obedient to God, if there is no connection, in no situation when you are in that problem, you will remember God.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
A small testimony of mine. In the month of Feb, I had newly joined in GMC as a staff nurse. It had become almost a week or so. There was another staff that spoiled my name. What state I would be, brothers and sisters? Panicked, fear, newly joined GMC. What is happening? I went back home, and when I went back home, I was again more disturbed because my cat got lost. My cat got lost the same day. It was like, what is happening? Today's day is the worst. I got my cat as the birthday gift, that Persian cat. I gave testimony also. That same day, my cat got lost for the first time. But luckily, it was in the housing. So I got my cat back. After I got my cat back, that same thing was running into my head. So then, next day, that night, I went in front of the Lord. I just sat in front of the Lord. And I said, Lord, what is happening? I newly joined GMC. I have not done anything wrong. What is she doing? And why is she doing it? That happened, slept. Next day, I got up, went for duty. I went for evening shift, sat there. Everybody's coming and supporting me.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Nobody dared to ask me what I did, but everybody in the department supported me. Being from the staff to the doctors to the HOD, every single person supported me.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. This is what happens when you have faith in God. I didn't even tell anything to brother. I didn't say anything to brother. But mama rang up brother and said such thing has happened to her, and she is, you know, all sad and all panicked. Next day brother called and asked what happened. I'm praying for you. And I told him everything has already settled.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
When you are in a big storm and remember your Jesus who died for you, the storm subsides on its own.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Let's go to the last scripture. Romans chapter 5 verse 8. But God demonstrates his own love for us in this. While we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Christ died for you. Christ died for me. And brothers and sisters, Christ is a symbol of faith to bring in you and me. He had to give up his son. He had to give him such a bad death so that he can bring about that faith in you and me. Otherwise, you and me would not have faith in our God. Because of Christ, he died on that cross. He had such a brutal death. Today, the few of us, and that few of us, are trying to change the rest to have faith in him.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.